All right, so let's get started. We're gonna do, let's get our Halloween started with our little gnomes. They're so cute. So always, I like to start with a nose because this is where it gives me the idea of where to put everything, right? And so I leave some space for the hat and for, you know, the moon or whatever else we want to do in the background, and also right here for our gnome. Now, knowing that I want the moon, for example, I'm going to go ahead and do a circle right here. Now, you can use some stencil if you want for your moon to be straight or circle, or you can, you know, get like the top of the bottle of a soda or something like that, and you can just create a circle around it. And then we're gonna have like maybe a tree over here coming out. So the tree comes like this, and then they don't have any leaves, right? And it's kind of spooky tree. Now, there's some things that like the hat is gonna come out here. So we're gonna erase potentially some of these lines, but making them ahead of time will make sure that we have a perfect circle in the background. Okay, so we go like this, and we have a little scary tree like this, and then maybe we have like a little spider coming down. So say we have like another branch right here, we just create like a spider web right there like that, and then this is where this is where it starts. So we go like this, and like this, right? Something like this. And then, oh no, not like that. Whoop. It goes like this. See, I don't even know what I do sometimes. And then we kind of create. See, from, oop, sorry. So basically, when you create a spider web, it's kind of like you have a little center, and then you make like a star in a way like that, and then you create like little curves around it like that. And usually like some of these like attach to something, so I'm attaching some of these lines into the branches. So, and then you just create little curves that go all the way inside to the center. Okay, all the way inside to the center, just like that. You do it to all of them, okay? So that's what I'm doing over here. So I created my center, and then here's, we have a branch, and we have another branch right here, and I just created, whoop, I think I made some of my lines backward, just like that, and then like this, and then, okay, and then we're gonna have a little spider coming down like here, and then we just create the little legs like that. Okay, so here's our gnome. So his mustache will come like this. We're gonna create a long mustache now. I don't think I've done like a wizard type of mustache. I don't know. We'll see how it looks later. Okay, and this is the hat. So the hat usually does this, covers the eyes, a long rectangle like that, and then I kind of make it your cricket. Doesn't have to be, it's Halloween, so it's gonna be a little cricket. So I turn right there, I'm making it super cricket. I'm gonna erase probably some of this. I'll continue, and then it kind of folds, and it's gonna make like a little square folding right there, like that, to make it a little bit, how do you say that? Funky swirl. And then his bird will come down like that, and he usually wear boots. I usually like to like boots, easy shoes, like, oh, like that, you see? His hands will come down like this, like he's behind. Behind his body. Okay? Make it easy. Like that. Okay? Let's get ready to paint. So if you like crayons, I'm gonna use some crayons, okay? Along with my paint. So here it is. About to paint, and then I thought maybe we should make him like a little cape, like a vampire cape. Yeah, want to do that? So maybe we have this vampire cape like that. Okay, and then on the other side, do the same like this. And then let's do some fangs like that. I don't know if you can tell they're fangs, but I had another one. I made another one with the mustache a little bit on the side, you were able to see, but I don't think the fangs work on this one, so maybe not. But if you do shorter fangs, or shorter mustache, like coming to the side, the fangs can come out on the side like that. Okay, so here we are going to use the purple. If you have a purple crayon, they resist the paint. So we go ahead and do the outline or drawing. Yeah. Or the outline of anything that is going to be purple. These are the arms, remember? And this is the back of the cape. And then this is kind of like the, oh wait, this is the beard. Well, maybe you have like a little shadow, purple shadow. So the beard is gonna be white. So I'm gonna do some gray. Do I have gray? No, I only have black. So I'm gonna go over with some. So let's paint purple. Let's paint purple. See, like that. And see how it resists with the crayons? And so you already have an outline that you're not going to lose. Ya tenemos la parte de atrás. Casi no hablo en español. I haven't spoken Spanish. I'm sorry. Pero así, miren. Tenemos las crayolas, hacen que el color resista, y ya tenemos la parte de las líneas trazadas. Y le voy a poner un poquito de morado aquí a la barbilla de nuestro gnomo, ¿por qué no? Estamos en Halloween, ¿verdad? Y también aquí el gorrito. Aquí a mi gorrito yo le voy a poner unas líneas también así como que diferentes colores, y de hecho tengo que borrar esta línea para que no se me quede el lápiz. No se me dejé mi goma, que no la encuentro, pero esta tiene poquita todavía. Okay. Y la parte de atrás vamos a hacerla. Es un árbol negro, así que vamos a ponerle un con plumón negro. This is going to be a black tree, so we can come back with a black marker at the end, and then kind of make that even darker. So I'm gonna leave the pencil on that on the tree just to have an outline. Pueden dejar el lápiz ahí para que después nomás le pasen con el marcador, un marcador negro, encima de la acuarela. And so what about if we make it like a little greenish, bluish color? Yeah, and do that. So we create, I'm gonna put more water here. I'm gonna create some spots here and there. Spooky night. I'm going around my moon. Okay. Creo aquí un círculo con el agua para no pintar la luna y dejarla blanca, okay? Y le pongo un poco de verde para hacerlo un poco spooky. Okay, y le pongo azul. Como si fuera así como que pociones mágicas de la bruja. We have magic potions from the witch. I don't know why the other day I was with my kids and we were singing "The witch, the witch, the witch is on fire," and they kept singing it over and over and over again. We kept singing it. I have no idea where I got it from. And I'm the one who started singing it. No idea why that was on my head, but it was. And we just started singing and singing and singing. And over here, the ground, I don't even know, but I think we're gonna make it, you know, brownish. And it's dark anyway because it's night. So we'll just create some, maybe some purple too. Maybe we can create some purple, but we can come back to it later. Let's do this. How about more green? The little hat of our nun. I'm just gonna create a lot of Halloween colors here, like that. And then maybe some orange. We don't have anything orange yet. Some orange. No tenemos nada naranja para los colores de Halloween. Así que voy a crear el gorrito naranja. ¿Sí? Y luego le ponemos el morado. And then we give it some purple. Perfect. Maybe we can do some polka dots or something. Because even though he's dressed up as a vampire, no gnomes are nice. Or are they? I think this little gnome is just plain trick or treat. But I guess we always have a little bit of everything everywhere. So this gnome might be a little bit a nutty one. What do you think? Este no es travieso. ¿Se porta bien o se porta mal? ¿Qué creen? Okay, I'm gonna turn this around so I don't mess up my painting. Y le sigo poniendo morado. Keep adding purple. ¿Verdad? Like create some gray. Oh, they're turning to orangey. It's okay. Pick it up. Pick it up with a brush. But maybe he dyed his gray beard into a Halloween purpley beard. What do you think? See, I love the blotchy, is that how you say it? Background with the, what you created with the watercolor. I love it. And remember, for the ground, you make lines to go across, and that will create the illusion of the ground, you know, because he's standing on something. You don't stand on sticks. You stand on a solid ground. Nos paramos en... Cuando hacemos líneas paralelas hacia los lados, creamos lo que es el piso. Es la ilusión del piso. Entonces, creamos esa ilusión de que nuestro gnomo está parado en el piso. Y es simplemente una ilusión, porque no nos paramos en palos, ¿verdad? Nos paramos en un piso sólido, y es lo que esto nos crea, esa ilusión de piso. Aquí va a estar nuestro arbolito y nuestra arañita. Puso mucha agua, por eso la estoy quitando. Nada más quería ponerle un poquito más oscuro. I wanted to just add some darkening points here. Cover my moon by mistake. It's good to put like a sticker or something so that you don't do that. But you know what? Like I always say, it's okay. It's something feasible. And in fact, well, I need to wear a little bit till it dries. And since I'm so impatient, I have my dryer. You can also use a blow dryer. background because that makes my paper come back straight. Okay. And now the little nose. We will make it a little bit, let's see, a little red. I love it. Gnomes with red noses. Yeah, I made this. I don't know if this is supposed to be like the gown or not or what. What do you think? I mixed the gown and the beard in the same background. I guess you can create both. I don't know. You can play with it. Oops, I didn't mean to put this red. Oh, let's pick it up. There we go. And, well, I think I'm ready to outline. Let's see. Where is my... I can do it with a crayon to make it... But see, my black broke. See, so it's not... So you can do it, if you don't have a marker, si no tienen un plumón, pueden hacerlo con una crayola también. No sé cómo vaya a salir, pero, you can try. I don't know how it's going to turn out, but I like to... I'm using like the side of it because it's so sharp. Se puede hacer con esa línea porque ya está muy afilada. Como quien dice. Y después voy a regresar para hacerle un poquito más de sombras. Pero necesito ver el outline primero. Do the outlining and then come back and see how it's looking. To give it more outline. And here it's kind of hard to see how it's looking, but that's what more or less what it looks like. Okay, more or less. I didn't make the shoes black, so I need to go back and just creating some shadows. Así creamos un poquito más de sombra. Y aquí también le voy a poner un poquito más de... Y nuestro árbol, our tree, going to be like this. It can be with a marker too. Pueden hacerlo con su plumón si gustan, si prefieren. A veces es más fácil hacerlo con plumón. I do this with a very, very, with a pen that is very, very fine, because that will work much better for the fine line. It's good to take that in context, how fine your lines are, so that you can create the right shadows. And over here I'm going to just make some brush strokes, brochazos. And with some diluted gray, I'm going to create more and more shadow. Con esto podemos crear más sombreado para dar la impresión de que no está completamente flat, plano. Okay, let's wear a little bit and come back to it. So it dries. Okay, now it's dry. So we can go with our marker, with our Sharpie. And we are going to give it more of a defined outline. And you know what I want to try to do? You know how square this is? I'm going to do something. I'm going to create his beard behind. See, like that? Why not? And that way I can create his robe as well. There we go. And that way we can give him a robe, an appropriate robe, and we can paint this another color. That way, he is more like, it's not a, such a square robe. I'm like, why does it look a little weird? It's because of that. his way, you're creating a mysterious so I give it more black outline, random black lines to the hat. And then I'll make some polka dots right here. Just because they're still cute. Right? And then here for the robe, maybe it can be black actually. We'll create a better contrast. Right? I think that's better. There we go. Much better. I like it more. But you do what makes you happy. Okay? Remember that. Let me create just random lines like this. Just because he's a gnome. In the orange stripe, I'll make that those lines, and I might go around and kind of create that outline for the moon, for my tree. Create some trees in the background if you want. You don't have to. Especially if you don't have them on with pencil first. Some ground. I think we need to make our ground a little bit darker. So let's do that. gray and black. Vamos a hacerlo un poquito más oscuro. Just because in the dark you cannot tell how white or how gray or how black everything is. So we're just gonna give him that aspect of, how would you say, like a mystery. The mysterious numb. This is too thick. Let me find a finer line. Here it is. These will do. I'm gonna have one of the thickest line there, but well, and then this is not working. I really, really want to make a heart. Really, really do. So I'm going to make it right here. You know me, I cannot go without hearts. And then some random swirls. All right, friends, and there we have our precious little Halloween gnome. Well, you know what? I'm gonna write boo-hoo. Trick or treat. Boo, because boo is international. You can say boo in English and in Spanish. Boo. That's cute. All right. I hope you enjoyed. Yay.